Good morning, students. Welcome to another online theory class in PERIO. So today's topic is biofilm and plaque microbiology. Okay, so before I start, do you know that there are a lot of microorganisms in you? That everybody must be knowing, right? There are a lot of microorganisms in you, but do you know how many are present? How many microorganisms or how many bacteria are present in you? It is stated that about 2 kg of the total body weight is comprised of the total bacterial population in a person. Okay, so 2 kg of your body weight is made of bacteria. That many microorganisms are present. So what do they do? Like, are they destructive always? No. Most cases, mostly in healthy cases, they live in a state of harmony with the host cells. Okay, so they will mind their business and the host cell minds its own business. So it lives in a state of harmony. Okay, so sometimes what happens is harmony is lost. And once the harmony is lost, disease occurs. Okay, so the next heading according to Carranza is the oral cavity from a microbe's perspective. So to help you understand this, I thought, why microbes perspective? From human perspective, I'll give you another example. Okay, for example, if you take the globe, okay, I don't really know how good an example this is, but if you take the globe, there are some places which will be desert like, there'll be some places in which there is snow, there are some places which are very hot, some places in which there is constant rain. Okay, so there are different environments or different ecosystems, okay, and second thing that I can tell in the same example is, whichever environment it is, there will be a Malayali everywhere. Okay, so similarly, coming to the microbes perspective, it states that there are, in the oral cavity, there are 6 major ecosystems, like 6 different environments in the oral cavity only. Okay, so one is your intraoral hard surfaces, like your teeth, your restorations and all. The next is subgingival region, which is your periodontal or peri-implant pocket region, root cementum. The next is the buccal and palatal mucosa. The next is the dorsum of the tongue, tonsils, saliva. So these are the 6 ecosystems that are present in the oral cavity. And like a mallu, there are certain specific types of microorganisms which are present in all these 6 types. Okay, so that example ends there. Okay, next is bacteria and their biofilm mode of living. Now what does this state? This microorganisms or bacteria, if they are present like, you know, in a freelance state, like not together type, then they are called as to be in a state of planktonic stage. Okay, so if they are in a planktonic stage, they are easily swished off or swirled off. Like, you know, if there is any water spray and all, it will get easily dislodged. Okay, whereas certain bacteria, they will form proper colonies. Okay, like how human beings have proper colonies to live, they have proper colonies. If they come together and if they build a colony for themselves in whichever ecosystem, then the game changes. Okay, so what do? In these colonies, they will have a specific drainage system, they'll have a specific colony of water channels, they'll have an organized area in from where they can collect the nutrients. They will even have communication with each other, by the way, like how you have mobile phones. Okay, so how do the bacteria communicate with each other? They will help release signals, okay, which help them to communicate with the neighboring bacteria. That is somewhat, I think I'll explain it to you in detail, but this concept of, you know, communication of bacteria with each other, it's called quorum sensing. Okay, quorum sensing, it's very important. I'll explain in detail later. So right now we spoke that these bacteria, if they are in a free stage, then they're not very strong. If they come together and they have made a colony for themselves, then they are stronger. Okay, and that is called the biofilm. Okay, now this plaque biofilm that you call, it will have organic constituents and inorganic constituents. Organic constituents are your glycoproteins, proteoglycans, lipid materials, DNA. Okay. And inorganic components are calcium, phosphates and fluorides, potassium and all those things. So basically it is like in a matrix, okay, it is present. These microorganisms are present in a matrix. These colonies are formed inside a matrix. Okay, now, so I will tell you the definition of dental plaque biofilm. I hope that you understand it very well. Dental plaque is defined clinically as a structured, I told you, colony, structured, resilient because it's difficult to destroy their colonies. Okay, unlike those microorganisms that are present in the free stage, it's difficult to destroy them. So they are resilient. Yellow grayish substance that adheres tenaciously to the intraoral heart surface, including removable and fixed restorations. They will adhere tenaciously to the intraoral heart surfaces, which can either be your removable processes or your fixed processes like your crown, your implant crown or the natural tooth. Okay, so that is that. This soft accumulation which can be swished easily, in which the bacteria are not in proper colony form, that is called as materia alba. Okay, and this proper colony form is called as the dental plaque. Whereas when this plaque calcifies, it forms a hard deposit on the tooth surface, and that is called your dental calculus. Okay, more explanation regarding what the differences are is given very clearly in Karanza, and it's really very simple. You can read it on your own. So there is materia alba, then there is plaque, and there is calculus. Now this plaque that I told you, if it is present above the gingival margin, then it is called as supragingival plaque. Okay, if the plaque is present below the gingival margin, it is called as subgingival plaque. Okay, over here there is another thing that I want to tell you. If it is supragingival plaque, it is stated that this plaque derives its inorganic constituents from the saliva. And that is why wherever your salivary ducts are opening, like the buccal surface of your upper molars, the lingual surface of the lower anteriors, okay, so in these areas there will be more supragingival plaque, okay, because it derives nutrients from the saliva. Whereas in subgingival conditions, it derives its nutrients from the fluid called as gingival crevicular fluid. Okay, so I hope supragingival plaque and subgingival plaque is clear to you. Okay, now in the subgingival plaque, there is another diagram in Karanza. Okay, I'll just try to show you it. Yeah, it's clear enough. Okay, so this is the area in which subgingival plaque is present. Okay, now you will see in the subgingival plaque, maybe because of the change in the microenvironment in each area, the type of microorganism that is predominantly present in the tooth side will be different compared to the type of microorganism that is present in the soft tissue side. Okay, I think my point is clear, right? The type of environment is different here, so different types of microorganism like to stay here. Whereas the environment is different here, so different types of microorganisms like to stay here. Now, what are the type of microorganisms that prefer to stay in the tooth area is predominantly gram-positive organisms, gram-positive rods and cocci. Okay, whereas in the soft tissue area, larger number of filaments and gram-negative organisms are seen. Okay, marginal plaque is of prime importance in the initiation and development of gingivitis. Okay, this is very important. Supragingival plaque, I told you about the gingiva. Supragingival plaque and tooth associated subgingival plaque are more so responsible for root caries. Okay, caries on the tooth and root caries this side. Whereas tissue associated plaque is more so involved in tissue destruction and different types of periodontitis. Okay, so that is the difference, tooth associated and tissue associated. The type of organism which likes that particular type of environment is different, and what it eventually causes is also different. Okay, now next, coming to formation of dental plaque, what I realized from my other videos is that if the video is too long, then people don't tend to watch it till the end. So I'll take dental plaque in two parts. Okay, so in this part I'll just talk in brief about the formation also. Okay, the next video will be the remaining contents. Okay, how is the formation? Formation of dental plaque is in three steps. Very simple. One is formation of pellicle. Next is attachment of bacteria. Third is colonization. Formation of pellicle means what? On any clean tooth surface, okay, there will be a layer of organic material. There will be a layer always on any tooth surface. They have even tried experimentally in volunteers, and they found out that within 1 minute or within 2 hours, there will be a fully formed organic layer that forms on any tooth surface. And now this layer is called as the organic pellicle. It contains more than 180 different types of peptides, proteins, glycoproteins, keratins, mucins. What does this pellicle do? Okay, it forms as the base in which they have certain receptors. Okay, and so that's the first step, formation of pellicle. The pellicle is formed, and the pellicle is such that they will have certain receptors. Okay, now the next step is attachment of bacteria. There are certain microorganisms, certain bacteria, which will come and attach to the receptors in the organic pellicle. I hope I have not complicated it for you. There is something called as the organic pellicle. Always an organic, this is your enamel, there is always a layer of organic pellicle on top. Okay, and this organic pellicle contains certain receptors. Okay, now certain specific microorganisms have extensions which will come and fix properly into these receptors. Okay, and those microorganisms which come and attach to the receptors of the organic pellicle are called as your primary colonizers. The microorganisms that came first, the primary colonizers. Now primary colonizers are what? Streptococcus mitis, Streptococcus aureus, Aeconella corundens, all these are your primary colonizers. Yeah, now next, coming to the secondary colonizers. Now how does the secondary there's something more about the primary colonizers that I want to tell you. These primary colonizers are microorganisms, right? So they have come and attached there, and once they get attached there, they change the microenvironment of that particular area. Okay, so the microenvironment is changed. That is one advantage. Second advantage is, now this has attached to the pellicle, its receptors. They have multiple other receptors. Okay, so what is the advantage? So many different types of microorganisms or bacteria can come and join to them. Okay, so they are called your secondary colonizers. Now these secondary colonizers, if you are to remember the names of them, most periodontal pathogens, these names will be very common in different types of periodontal disease for you. P. gingivalis, Treponema denticola, Aggregatibacter actinomycetum comitans, Provertella intermedia, all these are periodontal pathogens, and all these are secondary colonizers. Means what? They will come and attach to the primary colonizers. Okay, so I think this much for now. I'll once again explain from the beginning just the important points. 2 kg of your body weight, bacterial population. They live in harmony with the host cells. Disharmony, disease. Okay, different types, 6 different types of ecosystems in the oral cavity, and in all the 6 there are certain pathogens which are common. Okay, then bacteria that are just freely present in a planktonic stage, not very strong. If they are present in a colony form, they're 1,000 times more stronger. Okay, they have their own water channels, drainage channels, communication, quorum sensing, all that is present. And if you are to tell the composition of dental plaque, then you have organic components and inorganic components. Organic components, you have glycoproteins, proteoglycans, polysaccharides. Inorganic components, you will have calcium and phosphate and some amount of fluoride, some amount of potassium, all those things. Okay. And structurally, this is different from materia alba, in which the microorganisms are just loosely connected to each other and can be easily switched, whereas the calculus is hard deposits that are formed. Okay. And there is dental plaque. Now this dental plaque you can divide as supragingival dental plaque and subgingival dental plaque based on where it is present. If it is supragingival, they say that it derives most of its inorganic constituents from the saliva, whereas subgingival dental plaque derives most of its constituents from the gingival crevicular fluid. And in subgingival area, there is something called as tissue associated, tooth associated. The tooth associated will be mostly gram positive organisms, and they'll be more prone to cause root caries. Okay, whereas the tissue associated one will be more of gram negative and filamentous organisms, and they'll be more prone to cause gingival destruction. Okay, basic, at least this much if you know, it's enough. Now, formation of dental plaque biofilm. One is the formation of pellicle. Formation of organic pellicle is found on the enamel surface, and this organic pellicle will have certain receptors. They will help in the attachment of bacteria, which is step number two. Attachment of certain bacteria which contains receptors which will go and, like, you know, fix properly in your the primary colonizers are bacteria which contain the receptors which will go and attach to your organic pellicle. Okay, they will go and change the microenvironment there, and they also have large number of different types of receptors, and thus they will help in other microorganisms to come and join. So those are the microorganisms are your secondary colonizers. The names of secondary colonizers are very important: Fusobacterium, Nucleatum, P. gingivalis, Tryponema denticola, Aggregative Bacter. All these are, you know, renowned periodontal pathogens. They cause periodontal disease. Okay. So now there are factors that affect the supragingival dental plaque formation. I think from there onwards, I'll take in my next video. Okay. So please go through, please subscribe. If any doubts and feedbacks, I'd be very happy if you can comment on YouTube. Thank you.